Dobar dan, djeco, i dobrodošli na sat engleskog jezika za treći razred osnovne škole. Moje ime je Martina Supančić i bit ću danas vaša učiteljica. Naša današnja tema je rooms and furniture, odnosno prostorije u kući i namještaj. Ako ćete danas pozorno pratiti, na kraju današnjeg sata znaćete imenovati namještaj u kući, razvrstati namještaj u kući po točnim prostorijama i napisati jednostavan tekst o svom domu i prostorijama u njemu prema predlošku koji ćete danas dobiti. Za današnji sat potrebni su vam pametni telefon, laptop ili računalo s internetom, olovka i bilježnica. Now you'll meet my friend Tom. Tom is from London and he's 10 years old. He'll help me teach you about rooms and furniture today. First we have to revise the vocabulary from the last lesson. Dakle, prvo moramo, da bismo naučili novi vokabular, ponoviti vokabular od prošlog puta koje smo radili, a to je rooms in a house. I hope you remember everything. So, look at the first picture. What room is it? Yes, it's a kitchen. In the second picture, we can see a bathroom. That's right. In the third picture, we can see, yes, a bedroom. In the fourth picture, we can see, yes, a living room. In the next picture, we can see a dining room. Then we can see a hall. And in the last picture, we can see a garden, which is not a room, but we can usually see it around our houses. As you can see from the picture, Tom's family has just moved into their new house. In the first picture, you can see furniture removers, and in the second picture, you can see furniture. What does furniture mean? Furniture means namještaj. So furniture removers are the people who help you move your house. So what furniture items do they have to put into the kitchen? Repeat after me. Ponavljajte za mnom. A fridge, a cooker, a sink, a cupboard, a mirror, a wash basin, a toilet, a bath, a bed, a wardrobe, an armchair, a sofa, a lamp, a TV, a carpet, a table, and chairs. And now it's your turn to put the furniture items into the right rooms. So where shall we put a bath? Of course, into the bathroom. What about a cooker? Yes, we have to put it into the kitchen. What about a bed? Yes, it should go into the bedroom. What about a sofa? You're right. We have to put it into the living room. What about a table and some chairs? Yes, they should go into the dining room. What about the toilet? Of course, it should go into the bathroom. What about a fridge? Yes, that's right. It should go into the kitchen. What about a wardrobe? Of course, it should go into the bedroom. And what about a TV? We usually have to put it into the living room. What about a sink? It should go into the kitchen. What about a wash basin? Yes, we should put it into the bathroom. And what about a cupboard? That's right. It should go into the kitchen. What about the lamp? We can put it into the living room. What about the carpet? Yes, we should put it into the living room too. And our last item is an armchair, and we also have to put it into the living room. As you can see, Tom has a very big problem now. The removers have put all the furniture items into the wrong rooms, so you have to help them to find all the wrong furniture items in every room. So what do you have to do? You have to cross the odd one out. Do you know what it means? It means izbaci uljeza. Dakle, vi ćete sada pomoći Tomu i ljudima koji pomažu u njegovoj selidbi da u svakoj prostoriji pronaću uljeza, odnosno ono što u nju ne pripada. Are you ready? Okay, let's start. So what is wrong in the bedroom? Yes, a cooker doesn't belong here. What is wrong in the dining room? Yes, a mirror and a TV don't belong in the dining room. What is wrong in the kitchen? Of course, a wash basin and a sofa don't belong here. What about a hall? Of course, a bath doesn't belong into the hall. What is wrong in the living room? Yes, you're right. A fridge and a wash basin don't belong here. What is wrong in the bathroom? A sofa and, of course, a lamp don't belong here. And now it's time for you to play. You can pause the video now. Djeco, sada možete zaustaviti video jer je vrijeme za igru. Dakle, u svoju adresnu traku upisat ćete ovaj link ili ćete s pomoću svog mobitela skenirati ovaj QR kod. Kada ga skenirate, on će vas dovesti do Wordwall igrice, odnosno kviza, pomoću kojeg ćete provjeriti svoje znanje o namještaju i prostorijama u kući koje smo danas naučili. Good luck with the game! And now it's time for us to revise something. We have to revise the expressions which we usually use when we describe our rooms and houses. Dakle, sada ćemo ponoviti izraze koje obično koristimo kada opisujemo svoj dom ili svoje prostorije u kući. Dakle, prva je there is, koju koristimo s jedninom, odnosno koju koristimo uz imenice u jednini. For example, in my living room there is a sofa, an armchair, a TV, a carpet and a coffee table. Vidimo da imenice a sofa, an armchair, a TV, a carpet and a coffee table su u jednini, pa smo zbog toga uz njih koristili izraz there is. Za razliku od toga, izraz there are koristimo s množinom, odnosno s imenicama u množini. For example, in my living room there are two pictures on the wall. Two pictures, dvije slike, to je množina, i zbog toga smo koristili izraz there are. And now you'll hear Tom describing his home. You have to listen and look very carefully, because after Tom, you'll have to do it by yourselves. Dakle, sada ćete čuti Toma koji opisuje svoj dom. Morate pažljivo slušati i gledati, jer nakon toga bit će red na vas da i vi također opišete svoj dom. Are you ready?
I live in a house. There are six rooms in my house. A bedroom, a living room, a dining room, a kitchen, a bathroom, and a hall. My favorite room is a living room, because I can relax and watch TV there. In the living room, there is a sofa, a TV, a picture, a carpet, and a lamp. I love my home very much.
Okay, as I already said, now it's your turn to do it. Sada ćete, djeco, uzeti bilježnicu, pauzirati ovaj video, malo ćete ga zaustaviti i sami ćete napisati sastavak kratki o svom domu. Dakle, što trebate napraviti? Pogledajmo prvu rečenicu. I live in a house or a flat. Dakle, tu ćete odgovoriti živite li u kući ili u stanu. Druga rečenica. There are rooms in my house or flat. A bedroom, a living room and so on. U drugoj rečenici ćete morati napisati ovdje koliko prostorija ima u tvojoj kući ili u stanu i nabrojati ih. For example, there are 5 rooms in my house. A bedroom, a living room, a dining room, a kitchen and a hall. U sljedećoj rečenici morat ćete reći koja je vaša omiljena prostorija i zašto. For example, my favorite room is a kitchen because I like pancakes which my mom makes every week, for example. I u zadnjoj rečenici, dakle, morat ćete nabrojati što sve se nalazi u vašoj omiljenoj prostoriji. In the kitchen, there is a cooker, a sink, and a cupboard, na primjer. Ili, in the kitchen, there are 2 cupboards. I sastavak ćete završiti sa ovom rečenicom I love my home very much, because we all love our homes. Kada ste to napravili, sada je vrijeme da vidimo jesmo li sve napravili onako kako smo trebali. Da provjerimo, zato imamo ovu checklistu. Pa da vidimo. Ako si napisao ili napisala gdje živiš, u kući ili u stanu, možeš si staviti jednu kvačicu. Super! Ako si napisao ili napisala koliko prostorija se nalazi u tvom domu i ako si ih sve nabrojao, ponovo kvačica. Ako si napisao koja ti je omiljena prostorija i zašto, opet bravo, to si napravio dobro. Ako si napisao ili napisala što se sve nalazi u tvojoj omiljenoj prostoriji, dakle ako si nabrojao sav namještaj koji se nalazi, opet kvačica, super. I na kraju, ako si koristio pravilno there is sa jedninom i there are s množinom, opet bravo, kvačica i tvoj sastavak je super. And now it's time for assessment. A sada je vrijeme da provjerimo koliko smo uspješni bili na ovom satu. If you can name all the furniture items in the house and you understand everything, well done, good for you. Ako znaš nabrojati sam namještaj u kući, ako sve razumiješ, bravo za tebe, super. If you can name some furniture items in the house and you need more practice, that's okay too. A ako znaš nabrojati neke komade namještaja u kući, a neke još ne i trebaš još vježbati, to je isto okay. But if you can't name furniture items in the house and this was too hard and you need help, then you have to practice more. Ali ako ne znaš nabrojati namještaj u kući, ako ti je ovo bilo preteško i trebaš pomoć, onda moraš još puno vježbati. Ali ja ne sumnjam da ćeš ti to napraviti i da ćeš na kraju uspjeti, samo treba biti uporan. So dear children, this was all for today. I hope you liked this lesson. I hope that you learned something new and that you had fun. I hope to see you again really, really soon. Have a nice day and goodbye. Bye everybody!